To the Philippine Stock Exchange now, the local bourse seeing a negative end to the trading week a day after the release of the lower second quarter GDP growth. The PSE's main index shed 0.7% to settle at 6,400 level. Value turnover remained anemic at 3.5 billion pesos. Now, the market continues to react to the latest disappointing GDP figures indicating a sluggish economic growth this year. How far-reaching are its effects on consumption and the market itself? Joining us on the show is AB Capital Securities Vice President Jovis Vistan. Thanks for being on the Business Roadshow again, Jovis.
Thank you for having me, Stanley.
Let's start. Yesterday's GDP print, 4.3%, still setting the tone for today's trading. Now, Jovis, what's a slowing economy worth to our investors?
Well, obviously the disappointing numbers were below consensus. What this meant to the market right now is that the expectations were set too high. The bar was too high, and the numbers that came out were actually too far off. So it was a big miss in that sense. So, so anything that off that much would merit a sharp pullback in share prices. Not only was it lower than expected, Stanley, it's really way lower than the first quarter numbers, which is indicating that we should expect a slew of downgrades in terms of projections on economic growth from this point onwards.
All right, we'll go back to economic projections later. Let's talk about the market first, the equities market in particular. Now, aside from the disappointing growth figure, what else do you think worries the market now, which has been struggling to sustain its recent upward momentum?
Well, Stanley, the main problem continues to be an old problem, and that's the direction of monetary policy, both local and globally. Well, right now, inflation is again rearing its ugly head. Basically, the reason why we're seeing inflation go down in terms of headline inflation is because we're looking at it from a high base last year. So, but if you look at month-on-month inflation, we're slowly seeing some pickup in consumer prices, and that's going to put a lot of pressure on interest rates going forward. If rates were not to go up, at least we should expect high interest rates to stay for the meantime. Now, inflation, obviously, we're looking at prices like food items like rice hitting 15-year highs in the global market. WTI crude, of course, and Brent crude has been going up. So there's a lot of pressure on the supply side right now, Stan.
All right, Jovis, it is increasingly likely that we will not achieve full-year targets for growth as we speak now, given the new numbers. Now, what to you is a realistic target, given what we know so far?
Well, we still have to crunch our numbers, Stanley, you know, but I would imagine we should be closer to around between 5 to 5.5% for this year. But that's, I think, an optimistic target, because if we're looking at the second half of the year, the conditions would be much difficult compared to that of the first half, because we have to contend with the weather phenomenon, the El Nino phenomenon. As I speak right now, we started experiencing all of these price pressures on select commodity items just this July. So all of these things will be felt in the second half of this year. Moreover, the effect of high interest rates and its lag effect on consumer spending will also be felt in the second half. So I think that's a bit optimistic, but hopefully the saving grace would be other sectors should pick up where consumer spending has started.
Okay, now using the Fitch numbers as jumping board, 5.3, that's from 5.9 growth expected for the Philippines in 2023. Do you think that is sensible?
It's still early to say, Stanley, but I think it's achievable. But what I can say, Stanley, is that we were regarded as one of the best in terms of growth projections for this year and next year. That would be hard to achieve this time. That's for sure. But whether 5.3, as I said, we still have to crunch our numbers and see more data to come in the coming weeks.
Okay, now factoring in that number with corporate earnings now, at least for the next two quarters or last two quarters of the year. Now, if growth momentum is in fact decelerating, is it now safe to assume, Jovis, that earnings for many companies may have already peaked in the first and second quarters? And are you expecting more subdued revenues in the last two?
Well, again, under very difficult economic conditions, it would be very hard for us to sustain growth going forward. One of the reasons why growth has been strong is because of the emergence of revenge spending and revenge travel. We might see a continuation of that, but to a lesser extent.
Okay.
As I mentioned, with high interest rates, that's going to affect consumer spending. And the global economy's weakness with possible recession scenarios like in the US and China, unable to pick up yet their economy, even on the external trade side, would be a problem.
Yes, in fact, the growth figures, Jovis, don't you think that is already telling of the waning consumer spending and revenge spending, if you will?
I agree, yes. If you look at the second quarter results, there's a sharp drop in terms of consumer spending. So we're beginning to feel that momentum is waning.
All right. Now, one of the steps the government is taking is, of course, to speed up spending, particularly infrastructure, construction, that is, of course, to boost the economy. Now, what other interventions do you wish to see to arrest the growth decline?
Well, I think one sector that was weak also in the second quarter, a sharp drop was agriculture, Stanley. I think right now we have a situation that potentially we could have a global food shortage, and we should prioritize more resources to agriculture for us to be more independent right now. Obviously, as I speak now, prices of basic commodities are going up, and inflation can affect consumer spending going forward. Another thing that needs to be done by the government, you already mentioned, is to pump prime the economy. Obviously, with the weakness in the private sector, the government needs to come in and spend and hopefully create jobs that would generate more economic growth.
All right. Lastly, what's your market guidance for the coming trading week?
Well, we're exactly at a key support level, Stanley. Hopefully, all the negatives are already priced in.
Okay.
The negative momentum is there. We need to see some bargain hunting to come in at 6,400. In case there will be persistent weakness going forward, the key support level should be around 6,200.
All right. Thank you so much, Mr. Jovis Vistan. Always a pleasure talking to you.
Yep. Thank you, Stanley.